Моє життя вічне і розумне приходить, мої смерті перейшов у життя. Істину, істину кажу вам, надходить час войти тепер мій, коли померли, почує голос Сина Божого, і почувши оживу. Бо я потис моє життя у собі, так і Сину дав, щоб мав життя у собі, і дав йому владу з Отцем єдним. Бо він Син чоловічий, не дивуйтеся цьому, бо надходить час, коли всі, що в гробах, почують його голос, і великі, що чинили добро на воскресіння життя, а ті, що чинили зло на воскресіння суду. Не можу я нічого діяти для себе самого, я все ж так, як чую, і собі справедливий, бо я шукаю не моєї волі, але волі того, хто послав.
Thank you.
Blessed are they whom you have strolled into the realms of you, O Lord. righteousness, voluntary and involuntary.
Please be seated. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory be to Jesus Christ.
Glory be forever.
Слава Ісусу Христу.
Слава на віки.
Дорогі брати і сестри, сьогодні ми зібралися в нашому храмі святого великомученика Єсуфата, щоб провести останню дорогу покійного слугу Божого Івана Саварина, якого Господь Бог покликав до свого вічного дому на 91-му році життя. Він прожив довге, гарне, побожне християнське життя. І саме в сьогоднішній день його душа стоїть перед Богом і звітує за свої прожиті дні, які він прожив на землі. Ніколи є туди, де брати систему Christ. To pay our last respect to a member of our parish, John Savaryn. This is not the first time we have come together and said farewell to our friend, parishioner, family member. Hence, we sometimes wonder why do we live here on this earth? Is the purpose of our lives existence itself? Or is this the solution of our human organism? How can we explain the fact that this person who was alive moved and thought now lies motionless, lifeless? Certainly, death cannot be the purpose of our existence, for destruction cannot be the purpose of anyone, especially of a reasonable being as a man. This personal life cannot be the purpose of our existence, because man has in his heart a craving for everlasting happiness. The purpose of our life must be something else. It is eternal. Death is only the necessary condition which leads to this life. As you know, dear brothers and sisters in Christ, God created us that we might someday return to Him. God destined this goal for us in the beginning of our existence. Our life here on earth is like a journey to God. It is a service to the Creator through which we will receive the happiness for which everyone seeks. This is how we must look upon our life and not think of it as an aim in itself. Otherwise, we would not be able to answer the question which comes to our mind when we look upon this body abandoned by the soul. If the development of this eternal life is the purpose of our existence, then why do we have death? Why do we suffer the loss of this life? If we accept the service of God as our aim in life, we will understand death, which is apparently so terrible for every living person. It logically follows that if our life is a service to God, there must be an end to this service. Every man who works and uses his energy expects a reward for the work he has done. So, also every one of us who serves God expects a reward for his service. God promised us this reward when he said, whoever gives to one of these little ones but a cup of cold water, amen, I say to you, he shall not lose his reward. God pays us for our service, not now, but at the end of this life, after death. As you see, the brothers and sisters, death is understandable and necessary for every one of us, because death is a time of reward, a time which ends our service to God. So, death opened the gates of everlasting happiness or everlasting punishment for us. We need not fear this. We need only to serve God faithfully and to see that our service is worthy of the reward. And death will be for us a dear friend. For no matter how good the service is, how easy it might be, it is always a burden. Every servant awaits the end of his work and his wages in Zion. No matter how much we like our work, we anxiously await the reward God promised us. Each of us should say with the same call, unhappy man that I am, who will deliver me from the body of this death. If this is so, we will today bid farewell to our brother in Christ, John. I will not to cry and complain. The long expected day of recompense has arrived for him. God, who placed him in his service, said that the time of service is over. Now is the time of reward. With our tears and complaints, we are unable to help the soul of the deceased. If he did not satisfy the justice of God for the trespasses of his former life, he cannot do so after death. But we, the brothers and sisters in Christ, can help him with our prayers, holy divine liturgies, and indulgences. This way we will best show our love in respect to the deceased. If we pray for him, and in this way help him before the throne of Almighty God, when our deceased friend is reunited with his Creator, he will help us by begging God for our salvation. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Spirit, amen.
Please rise.
Thank you.
Spirit, John was fed in sleep, and we give glory to you, together with your eternal Father, in your most holy, one and giving Spirit, now and forever and ever.
And lived through years of war, deprivation, and hunger. before ending up in a refugee camp in Wales. I can never do justice to the life of this man, who endures such hardship, scarcity, and change with great fortitude and resilience. He taught himself English, found work, and married my mother. He was always her hard worker and progressed as a well-respected mechanical engineer, in spite of local opposition to foreign workers at that time. I believe his early experiences led him to have a great appreciation of the simple but important things in life. And he had little time for what he considered to be frivolities. He was very warm-hearted and had a strong sense of right and wrong, which guided his actions. Unfortunately, the marriage ended in divorce. Oh, and this ended his cherished hope for a settled family life. The divorce and redundancy due to the closure of the plant where he worked led him to move to Canada to start a new life. The move was encouraged and facilitated by his brother after they were reunited through the Red Cross in the late 1960s. In Canada, he enjoyed taking part in extended family life and celebrations with his brother's family, who played such a central role in his life here. Particularly, Halia and Maya, who helped him so much during the later period of his life. He also established a long-lasting, happy relationship with the widowed Lena Gulltree. He was famous in family for growing vegetables, especially tomatoes, and fixing things, as he was always fascinated by the way things work, and would often come up with creative solutions to any mechanical problem. Unfortunately, his later years were plagued by ill health, but he never gave up hope and was resolute in appreciating his life until the end. I can never do justice to the life of this brave, kind-hearted man. As a father, he was always supportive and acted as both father and mother to me. So I mourn the passing of this tough but kind man. Thank you.
Slava Isusu Hristu. Буду говорити головно англійською мовою, щоб старі діти мене зрозуміли. Good evening, Claire, Mark, family and friends. Ivan, or Steg, as we all called him lovingly, was incredibly dear to us and an integral member of our family. His quiet, unassuming, modest manner, his non-judgmental and accepting attitude, his willingness to help out in any way, or simply to just hang out and shoot the breeze, made us all seek out his company any chance we got. Life gets invariably and impossibly busy for all individuals. And knowing that he was there for us anytime life slowed down for a minute was invaluable. Something's broken, Stray can fix it. Need a strong back and capable hands? Stray's sharing your load. Want a quiet chat over tea or a few beer? He's at home and available. Have a problem with which you're wrestling? He's open-minded and eager to share his life experience and wise perspective. Our family has had the joy and privilege to help him out as well throughout these past 41 years, much more so as his health deteriorated in the last 10. Over the course of his life in Edmonton,
He's made numerous kind and loyal friends with whom he shared a multitude of interests. He sang with my mom, Oya, in the Dnipro choir for many years, traveling to a variety of locations on tours and performing here with them. He volunteered in any capacity needed for vital fundraising projects for numerous organizations, whether it was working the late shift at a casino, going door to door knocking to solicit votes for a candidate's political campaign, or even sitting at the entrance door of a venue taking tickets or donations at organized events. If someone was needed to pitch in, Stray Reliably was your man. Our Ukrainian community owes him a debt of gratitude for his many years of quiet service. Although Stejko was very much a solitary soul, later in life he was drawn to one special woman who made him really happy for many companionable years, and that lady was Pani Lina Gusan, or Auntie Lina, as Diana called her. Pani Lina's family embraced Stray Ivan as one of their own, including him in many a family celebration. To him, that relationship was precious. As Lana and Greg, Pani Pavlina, Diane's mom, Christia and Evhan, Pani Anna Svazdecki, Diane and Niko Groh, all helped him realize he was cherished in his own right. Our own children, Svetlana and Justin, Teja and Bohdan, Antonia and their children, Anna Sofika, Adria, Everest, Anatolia, along with Bodja and Aaron, Matria and Rajiv, Yurko and Solomia, Viruchka and Pavlo, Ulana and Mukasek, held Stray in high esteem and close in their hearts, for he was a wonderful and interesting man. Stray struggled patiently with increasing health issues in recent years. Isolative hearing loss, crippling gout, C. difficile, and digestive issues, weakening legs, loss of balance. But amazingly, he conquered a severe case of COVID this year, imagine, at age 91. As he was frequently fond of saying, "Не до повірення," only to discover that he developed cancer in his stomach and lungs, to which he sadly succumbed on October 6th. He desperately wished to leave this earth the way Petro, his oldest brother, had, painlessly, in his sleep. But unfortunately, that was not to be. I personally have always had a fascination with numbers and a love of coincidences, so allow me to share these few with you. My father, Ivan's brother, was born in 1926, and Ivan in 1930, 4 years apart. My father died in 2017, and Stray in 2021, 4 years apart. My father died on April 6th, our mother's birthday, and Stray Ivan on October 6th, same calendar day. Cool, huh? I think so. When my father died, Stray Ivan became our mother's shining knight, her self-appointed guardian and companion, a true brother. You see, they both lived at Rosedale Estates, her for a short time, him for longer. He would sit with her for all meals, ensuring she, in her semi-helpless catatonic state, would eat a healthy amount of nourishment, talking to her, keeping her sense of awareness active for as long as possible. When our mom, Oya, needed to move to Linwood Extended Care, and left Stray behind, he accompanied me almost every week to visit her, taking her for walks in all kinds of weather on the beautiful grounds of McConnell Place next door to Linwood, using his walker for his own stability while I pushed her wheelchair. When she passed away 2 years ago, 5 days short of the date of his own passing, he was greatly saddened, but accepting of its inevitability. In time, he also moved to Linwood Extended Care, where he shared a room with an engaging fellow, Clive, on the same floor and unit as Oya, for Parker Pavilion. Unfortunately, having to sell his home and move to smaller quarters without a garden necessitated him reducing his usual love of gardening to a huge degree. As Claire said, his giant sunflowers in a sizable garden became geraniums in pots in a front window. His entire garage wall covering tomatoes and pole beans became only a pleasant memory to be replaced by his vicarious enjoyment of our, Wayana and my, tomato and bean crops in our own garden. Such is life, I guess. A time for all things, and he certainly used his time well. Today, Yvonne's two children, Claire and Mark, and his two grandchildren, Matthew and Ashley, and Mark's wife, Teresa, brought him great joy, sharing their successes in school, sending cards and letters regularly throughout the years, making weekly phone calls and twice yearly visits to Canada from Mark and Claire, which infused him with contentment and affirmed that he was much loved by his family, direct and extended equally. His great-grandson, Frankie, was born 1.5 years ago, and Frankie's little sister, Savannah, was born just a day before Stu left this world. Such a pity he couldn't meet either of them due to his understandable inability to travel. He thrilled immeasurably, learning of their births, having already lived for the moments when he could spend time with our own grandchildren, invariably laughing endlessly at their antics and being utterly charmed by their natural, innocent joie de vivre. Although one always wishes to spend as long on Earth as God will grant us, the time inevitably comes for us all to return to his loving embrace. May Stray Ivach now reunite with his brothers, sister, and Oya in the spiritual version of their dearly beloved homeland, Kriina, for all eternity. Tujmo za vama Stray Ivach, naš dorohenki. Tjashko pohodeti se s plodjemi žitja, котрі приходять з вашого проведіння, лишаючи по собі велику страту і жаль. Любимо тебе безмірно, нехай канаті під земля тобі буде легкою, нехай буде тобі вічно, як мама за роду плід. Слава Ісусу Христу!
Oh, yeah.